De Britse prins Philip is overleden. Hij stond bekend als recht voor zijn raap.
Do you think it was the right thing to do?
No.
Een tikje ongeduldig, maar vooral als man van koningin Elizabeth.
He has quite simply been my strength and stay all these years.
Royalty-verslaggever Russell Myers schetst aan de hand van fragmenten een beeld van het leven van de hertog van Edinburgh. Op 20 november 1947 trouwde de 26-jarige Philip met de 21-jarige prinses Elizabeth.
It was a marriage out of love, and I think that over the years that they've been together, their relationship was emboldened by all the sort of trials and tribulations they had to go through, and they both spoke of each other very, very fondly throughout the years.
Hi Philip, to become your liege man of life and limb.
Op 2 juni 1953 werd Elizabeth gekroond tot koningin. Het duurde even voordat prins Philip vrede had met zijn ondergeschikte rol.
He did struggle in the early years. He was made to step aside from his very promising career in the Royal Navy and then essentially be by the side of his wife at all state of functions and functions to do with the monarchy. I think the way it was managed really was to try and give him a role. He was almost put on a par with the Queen in terms of the matters of state, and she really relied on his advice and counsel for all those years.
Op 14 november 1948 werd troonopvolger en oudste zoon Prins Charles geboren.
Well, I don't think he was a very hands-on dad at first. He had had quite a strict upbringing himself, and I think he took that forward to in his own style of parenting. He certainly had trials and tribulations with his own son, Prince Charles. He didn't necessarily think he was tough enough to be up to the job of potentially one day running the country. But that certainly changed throughout Charles's latter years.
Pay attention, because we are now going to see the world's most experienced placard veil.
De hertog van Edinburgh stond bekend om zijn humor en soms onbehouden uitspraken.
And it often got him into hot water. Some of his gaffes have been referred to as very, very cringeworthy. Certainly he's made some comments to women in skimpy outfits or people in ceremonial dress when abroad representing the royal family, and some causing offence at times, but I don't think they were ever meant to.
Quite a romantic gesture.
Finish. The Prince Philip's been involved in a car crash that turned the Land Rover he was driving on its side.
De laatste jaren kwakkelde prins Philip met zijn gezondheid. En op 17 januari 2019 veroorzaakte hij een auto-ongeluk.
Miraculously, he walked away with just bumps and bruises. He had managed to crash his car on a busy road, flip the Range Rover that he was in, and it led to him actually handing over his driving license. He voluntarily gave it up after speaking to the police. Thankfully, no one was injured. And, you know, he was the Iron Duke until the last, that's for sure.